Welcome back to New York City and the famed Central Park Croquet Lawns, hosting the Osborn Cup in September of 2022. Tournament director is Doug Moore. The lawns are just north of the Sheep Meadow there. And this event is maintained by the New York Croquet Club. Peter Timmins is the president and I think the tournament manager. Chris Patmore playing red and yellow. That's the first stroke on red, and I'll tell you how many strokes on red it takes to get somebody into this game. Chris is a -2.5 handicap. He's a longtime stalwart of the New York Croquet Club. And he's playing Mike Gibbons, who's playing blue and black. Mike lists West Palm Beach and the National Croquet Center as his home court now, but he is likewise a longtime New York stalwart. And his handicap is -1. This is a semifinal match to get into the final against Doug Moore, who beat David Isaacs in the other semifinal. It's an all New York semifinal and final. They're going to play the out game for a while, but I think it's mostly inadvertent, at least in the beginning. Paul Neubecker is your videographer. That's the second stroke on red. These lines are challenging to say the least. Any general shot is subject to random roll-offs. Shot number 3 on red. Number 4. If I were Chris, I would call a referee for this one. Number 5. number five.
I hit. I broke it.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I tried to send blue out. Black.
Number six on red. Number seven. Number eight. So eight full turns of four balls each, and somebody's finally in the game. All of a sudden, they can't miss. He's going to do something we recommend, although it's almost never relevant, putting that ball where it's not on the approach line to the hoop. So if Chris got in and went around when he made two back, he couldn't knock blue out of the way. Probably not relevant in these conditions. And in these conditions, these two are going to use Tices like that, trying to get the opponent dead, because they know the lawn is going to make it difficult to capitalize on this opportunity.
Number
to make a break for blue out of this. He's got to put black out there somewhere, and then that gives yellow two balls to shoot at. Deadness board is a standard deadness board with the addition of clip position in column two. Yellow doesn't have a rush. Any attack has to be a takeoff. And Mike figures it's worth the risk. And he figured right.
How was Oktoberfest?
Yes, you can answer that. It's a law's question. You can answer it. Don't give false information.
This assume I get you in frame on red or on the line shot. I kept moving it.
It was 50-50.
I kept moving it, and then you kept moving.
I was in two minds. I really wanted to shoot the black, but I could just see me hitting it on the left-hand side, and then now giving him a rush on yellow.
Yeah, and you already got burned by that line once.
And it was going really nicely. I thought I was actually going to hit the blue, and then it just froze on fire. Thinly attended.
Yeah, surprised no Rich Curtis this year. I feel like he's a staple at this, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. He's a good reason.
A lot of folks would call a referee to watch this, but it doesn't need to be watched because he can't move that ball without hitting it because it's not really on the stanchion. So even though he hit the stanchion first, as you'll see in slow motion, he actually hit the ball. Red and yellow are both for hoop two. Yellow's dead on red, but red's clean, so chance to get a break going for red. It's Peter Timmins over in the corner of the adjacent lawn. He's the president of the New York Croquet Club. One of my most enjoyable experiences on this venue was on that adjacent lawn playing doubles with Cynthia Gibbons, Mike's lovely wife. She has sadly since passed away and is sorely missed.
Reason you want, like, were you just hoping to get a hoop running shot with yellow to clear the deadness?
I was hoping I might be able to get a peel.
Okay.
Wonderful good position.
Red is only live on blue, and blue is in the jaws of hoop three. I hope he wasn't shooting at black because he's dead on black.
That was
some kind of New York code talking to the board keeper. And Red's deadness is the only thing that lets Mike do this. Yellow could do a takeoff to the attack, but he can't lay a break for Red because Red's dead on yellow and black, and of course Red can't rush yellow up there, so probably safe. I think he wants to go to hoop four with the blue ball because Red is dead on partner. Therefore, Red can't take advantage of any mistake that blue makes. Another way of saying that is blue has deadness rotation. And that's why he didn't give black the rush to hoop four with blue. And now if Chris puts red out on the lawn, giving yellow a rush to its hoop, then black can just take off and come get him.
Thank you.
black here. Right? By pitching for long shots to move.
Did once already, didn't I? Notice that blue has a pretty good rush to its hoop four on blind. And in easier conditions, he would have croqueted red beyond the hoop and tried to keep going. He's going to leave red there, which basically gives blue a three-ball break. In easier conditions, anyway. Maybe Chris knew that Mike wouldn't take the line rush, that he wanted a more direct rush to the hoop. Notice how high off the ground the string is here. That's what Chris went to look at, I think, before he did this. Saved by the string. Now, if Red had gone out, it wouldn't have mattered, but the string kept blue in, and this is one reason a lot of folks use chalk lines. The other is that people don't trip over chalk lines. So he couldn't get Red clean, and Red's now three ball dead, but he'll give yellow a hoop six pioneer. Mike's going to put black in line shooting position on hoop five. That's a little risky, though, because yellow could pick up black and run the break with the spin ball. But he doesn't want to risk it on the boundary, so he'll run the break with the danger ball. The advantage of using the spin ball, of course, is that, one, it diminishes the consequences of breaking down, and two, it makes the leave at the end easier. That's a nice shot. He wanted blue closer to one bag, but it's perfectly usable where it is. And after six, he'll play for the rush on red back toward two back, which will let him use blue very nicely. It's all humans and horses generating the power on West Drive over there.
We've to tie game. Christmas is this is gonna end his turn partner dead. For one day. So now Chris is up one.
Watch his toes. George Cochran is another really good player who does that.
We're also on the fence. I talked about it. It in my view, because it's the week after the 8th, right?
I don't know. It's November 3 or 6.
Yeah, it's that week after the week I was asking if you were going to be around if I came to Florida. So it's kind of, I got to do one or the other. I'm just trying to sell it to my wife as a vacation because it's not very heavy on the croquet, but what's if? looks, I look at flights, it's like, it's not short. It's like 8 hours of flight time. The connection. At the same time. Yeah, from here.
Oh, yeah.
He's pretty good at these nasty little angled hoops.
From here?
Yeah, Fort Lauderdale, Miami.
Oh, from Florida.
That's what I meant. You're right.
Yeah. Yeah, nothing from here.
So it's Thursday, Friday, so.
Oh.
And I have a room in a four-bedroom house down the street. Doug has one room. Who are the other people staying?
Well, that was another question my wife had. She said, well, do you know who's going to be there? And I'm like, I don't know who's going to be there. So okay, imagine Karen Tuckman. She lives there.
Yeah, Karen, Lady, Doug will probably be there. I'm on the fence about it. Maybe we'll come home a little bit.
Does JY show up for that?
No. I mean, maybe in the past, he sometimes has that doubt as well because he's about to fuck with.
Well, and you just had a hurricane. So.
Yeah, I talked to him about that. I got a message from him. It's just a lot of like, leaves and branches and shit. But I can't drink it, so it's good. They had no power, like, water pumps or anything. Aside from that, they were fine.
It's good.
Yeah, all easily drinkable.
So, like, the attractiveness of going to St. Croix came a lot less when I realized the commuting.
It's also got a little edge for me too because I won last year, so I in theory should go to defend that. But then subsequently, just the minor league nationals that Doug and I are going to play. I don't know that I want to take so much time.
1 minute, 12 seconds.
Okay.
And this is where running the break with a danger ball causes a problem. He feels he has to get rid of it now in case he breaks down at four back. Whereas if he were running this break with black, which he could have picked up at the beginning, he wouldn't have to stop now.
Striker ball, low kick.
Far be it for me to criticize the technique of a minus 2.5 to whom I've lost once. But Chris uses roll shots sometimes where I think he'd be better served with a standard drive shot or stop shot, especially around the hoops with so many roll-offs. Roll shots are dangerous in this situation. He's obviously stopping the break here, and he may have been playing for a scatter shot or a double tap shot on red to get both balls out of bounds next to each other. But that roll shot compromised the hoop shot. But overall, not bad. Red got three ball dead, and from that, yellow made a break from 6-4 back to go from one down to three hoops ahead. And the game must be almost over, or otherwise he'd go to the east boundary and give himself a line shot on four back.
Yellow is first last.
Challenging conditions indeed. And you heard that yellow is first ball in last turns. So blue has no shot, but black is nicely positioned for a break starting at hoop five.
This way he's got to do several good shots.
And this is why you should practice two ball breaks. Because making three on a two ball break starting at five is not that hard. And that would tie it up.
I just did it quick on the fly so you have something if you want.
Croquet sandwich, huh? It's not like tournament heavy, it'd be a little bit of a joint vacation.
Well, that's just it. It's more invitation style. When you're out having a good time, it's, you know, the eighth. It's just
like one day off or one and a half days off.
Is he set up correctly or is he doing the first thing?
What's that?
He started here.
He went that
He's
way.
On the wrong side.
And there you have it. With a nice break at the end, Chris Patmore takes Mike Gibbons by three hoops and moves on to the final in the 2022 Osborn Cup against Doug Moore. So give us a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. We'll have the final out in a few days. Thanks to the USCA for sanctioning and actually Stuart Price from Tulsa, Oklahoma for funding this effort. And we'll let some kind of relaxing dance class in Central Park take us out. Here's Temp Peck, another long-standing New York croquet player going by. And here's the USCA website. Because we are now the official YouTube channel of the United States Croquet Association.